I'd like people to know this about me, is that I'll never promise what I can't deliver, and that I'll always deliver what I say I'm going to. I think it's really important that people can have confidence that when I tell them this is what's going to happen, it will. And if there's any problem, I'll let them know. This is really important. People cannot go into this election thinking it's all just going to be easy. It's not going to be easy. It's going to be tough for New Zealand. As we can see, we've got a lot of people going through really hard times, and those people need to know that I'm there for them, and I will never let them down. Well, I grew up in the Waikato and on a farm, a dairy farm, with my mum and dad. And I had older brothers and sisters. They were all quite a lot older than me. And so I spent a lot of time quite a long way away from other kids my own age. So I grew up with cows and calves and dogs, farm dogs and cats, and training around with either my dad on the farm or my mum. When I was growing up, we used to have a lot of dinner conversations that were probably quite rowdy, actually. We'd talk politics, we'd talk about everything else that was going on, talking obviously about what was happening on the farm. We always had views, and we're all my family like that. We all have views, and none of us are frightened to say what we wanted. And we were fortunate because my mother and father were both of the view that if we could say what we wanted. And we're always respectful of each other, but it is important to be able to have an exchange of views, a contest of ideas. We used to have it every night at the dinner table. Well, when I was about 5 years old, my mother told me I should tell my very first teacher that I wanted to be a lady doctor. It was an old-fashioned term for, we'd just say now, doctor. So, because she didn't have a doctor in the family. And it was when I was about 14 I decided I actually wanted to do law. And I also really had seen these wonderfully powerful and strong women lawyers on television. I can't even remember what the programs were now, but there must have been something there. They sort of righted the wrongs and stood up for people. And I thought, oh, that's more like me. So I investigated, found out we didn't have any women lawyers anywhere around us. We did in Hamilton. And careers advisor organised for me when I was about 16, my mum and dad, to take me to visit Sylvia Cartwright, who was one of the first women lawyers in the Waikato. And I just talked to her and I thought, yeah, I could do that. And in Auckland, by the time I got to Auckland, I picked up part-time jobs. I was very focused, and everyone seemed to be very focused on working hard when I came to Auckland. I also met my future husband, David, at that time. So I was a lawyer for 20 years before coming into politics, but I also started and owned two restaurants in that time. So I was a lawyer, I was first a partner when I was 27 years old in a law firm, and from there I went on to actually set up my own firm as a sole practitioner with staff. And I did that because my husband and I decided that we wanted to start a family. And so I wanted to be in charge of everything. I didn't want to feel at all worried that someone might think I was spending too much time with my baby. So I ended up just creating my own work environment. So I was named Crusher back in about 2010, and it was when I said, look, I'm sick of these illegal street races going around intimidating police and the public, so it's about time we crush some cars. So at the time I was really didn't like that name at all, and it's not a name I use. But nowadays, it's funny, it's grown on me a wee bit. And nowadays when I see a little 2.5 year old who's now refers to me as Auntie Quasha, I think it's actually quite cute. and I was out recently doing a speech in Mana, north of Wellington, and a couple turned up, an engineering business, and they had this great big sign that says Crusher for PM, and I think it's probably a compliment now after all these years.
If I was to describe Judith in just one word, that would be decisive.
Time and time again I've been tested, and time again I've come through. I can make decisions, and I do listen to other people, as well as understanding my own instincts. I think it's important to be able to make decisions and then to follow through.
I describe Judith in one word as competent. She knows about the economy, she knows what she's on about, she does what she said she'd do.
COVID-19 has changed our world, and while Kiwis can all be proud of our collective health response, New Zealand is facing the biggest economic crisis in generations. National has the team and the plan to get us through. The only way to avoid another 3 years of chaos from Labour and the Greens is to party vote National.